Since the start of the year, one issue has dominated the headlines.
Singapore's inflation is at its highest in a decade.
Inflation jumped from January's 4% to 4.3% in February.
Consumer prices in Singapore are expected to further increase with rising inflation.
But even as prices increase all around, our supermarkets are holding prices steady for some products. We are talking about house brands. So, what exactly are house brands? Essentially, they are products marketed under a supermarket retailer's brand. FairPrice was the first to introduce house brands in 1985 for essential goods such as cooking oil, rice, and toilet paper. But these days, there are house brands for wine, baby products, and even electronics. According to Singapore's largest supermarket chain, FairPrice, their range of products grew by 25% over the last 2 years. Similarly, Dairy Farms, which owns Cold Storage and Giant, has indicated that its house brand Meadows has seen a 1,100% increase over the same period. Even online supermarket retailers like Redmart have witnessed an over 40% increase in house brand variety.
With inflation at a 10-year high and supermarkets offering more varieties of house brands, is it time to make that switch? Little has been reported on house brands here, so I'm commissioning a research company to find out what people really think of house brands, which categories are the most popular, and if we are buying more house brands over the last year. My survey results, which covered 500 respondents, are in. So more than half the respondents, 51%, say that they have increased their purchases of house brand products. This is compared to a year ago. The most popular products bought: bakery items like bread, drinks like coffee and tea, cooking ingredients like rice and noodles, household cleaners, and snacks and confectionery. The biggest reason for choosing house brand products? Price. Almost 91% of my survey participants make the switch because of this. Just how much does one stand to save buying house brands? Well, let me do the sums for my weekly shopping.
Oi? Individually wrapped. Okay, how much is it? $4. How many rolls? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So each roll is about 40 cents. These are some of the common grocery items I buy every week. This time, I have bought the house brand products as well as the branded options.
Hello, good morning.
Morning. When I buy only branded products, my bill comes out to?
$64.40.
Okay, let's move on.
All right.
I'm pretty sure there's going to be a price difference, but the question is how much? When I buy house brand versions of the same product, my bill comes up to?
$45.40.
Oh, it's almost 30% difference. That was about $19, savings of $19. I can buy one whole packet of rice. Thank you, PayWave, please.
Yes.
Doncha is a finance blogger. She keeps close tabs on her expenses. It's no wonder that in the last 3 years, she has turned to house brands. Okay, I'm going to raid Dawn's fridge for house brand products. Let's go.
Let me show you. Alright, so I have this. I stock up on this really often. Cheaper and tastes really good. I get a lot of like house brand frozen meats as well. And fish fingers, which are usually like for convenience lunches. House brand milk. And I also have like ham.
What I think is really interesting, it's only when you start looking at your fridge, then you realise that actually I have a lot more house brands than I think.
Yes,
do you feel that way?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I suspect that for most of us, we may not even know that some brands are house brands because we just buy them without realising that.
Yeah, exactly.
How long have you been using house brands?
I grew up with some house brands, although it wasn't as prevalent back then. And then when I was in my younger 20s and trying to save up aggressively, I did use quite a few house brands. So I would say maybe like one or two decades already.
Okay, then from your experience, have house brand products changed over the last two decades?
Yeah, for sure. I think one would be the variety. There's more products that they're bringing in. And then for quality wise, I remember like when I was much younger in my 20s and I bought house brand cotton pads to remove my makeup. Before I'm done with my whole face, it would like disintegrate. We all know how frustrating it is, right? Then you have to layer like one or two in order for it not disintegrate as fast.
Then in the end, no savings.
Exactly, exactly. But now, I went back to house brand cotton pads and I'm like, wow, it doesn't disintegrate as fast. It's definitely better from a user perspective.
What house brand product will you not buy?
Baby stuff, I'm a bit more sensitive. I chose the branded version instead. I think because like there's this perception that it's safer. I can skim more on myself. Mm. But when it comes to my kids, I would think twice.
Dawn is very much representative of the numbers revealed by my survey. When respondents were asked what they bought, only 31% said baby products. I think the reason lies in perception. My survey reveals that while most people opt for house brands because of cost savings, only slightly more than half of our survey respondents say they buy them because of their quality. But is that perception true?
So Diana, look at this. This is the branded. Okay. Do you see anything?
I want to know how Singapore's house brand products stack up against branded products. To find out, I'm gathering some of the most commonly bought house brand products according to Talking Point's survey and testing them for nutrition, taste, and efficacy. First up, nutrition. I want to know if house brand versions of essential foods like eggs, milk, and rice are nutritionally comparable. I'm passing house brand and branded versions of these food items to dietitian Lynette Goh. She's going to help me break down the numbers on the nutrition labels. Lynette, how are the products different?
Okay, let's start with the eggs. We've compared three types of eggs, two household brands and a branded egg. The eggs are quite similar in size. We look mainly at the protein differences between the three eggs. So when we compare them, household brand one has a comparable protein to the branded egg, whereas household brand 2 is 25% lower in protein.
Is this number significant?
Well, in the long run, if you look at your diet as a whole, while 25% may seem quite a lot, it's actually only 2 grams. That protein can be made up from other food sources. So it's not that significant.
Now let's move on to the milk. How do they compare?
Well, in terms of milk, we've compared two household brands and a branded milk, and they are quite similar in terms of calcium, which is the main thing that we look at when we look at milk. So while there are some slight differences, it's quite comparable.
Okay, and finally, let's talk about the rice.
So in terms of rice, we compared two house brands and a branded rice, and they are all the Thai Hom Lee rice. And we found that there's not much significant differences in terms of calories or carbohydrates as well.
Wow. So actually between the two house brands and the branded, you find that nutritionally, they are on par.
Yes.
When it comes to nutrition, the house brands were comparable to the branded products I tested. Even with slight variations in some nutrients, the levels aren't significant.
But let's face it, nutrition isn't the only consideration when we buy food. House brands have a wide array of snacks like chips, nuts and biscuits.
Okay, so I have got three different types of snacks and each snack has a house brand and brand name. I'm going to do a blind taste test with consumers to see if they have a preference. Okay, so what do we want to start with? You want to try the biscuits?
Sure.
Which one do you like better?
B.
I actually prefer A.
The brand is more expensive than the house brand.
Okay.
How will that influence the way you choose and how?
I think it's dependent on the product itself. But biscuit, if it's the pricing, probably play quite a big role.
Okay, now you try this one. Tastes the same. This is the house brand, which is cheaper than the brand. Some brand is cheap. Why? Elmo is Elmo. Which one do you prefer?
Better.
Would you pay more for this?
It will taste a bit better and it's not a lot.
Okay, now you taste this one. Which one will you buy? This one. Why?
Less salty.
This one is almost twice the price of this.
The more expensive one, the quality are there.
Daddy, your choice?
A.
You prefer A, MRB?
A.
A also?
Yeah.
Which one you like better?
A.
Is it yummier? Can you say?
It's sweet.
Oh, it's sweet.
More flavorful. I'll take this.
This one is the house brand.
Brand is due to promotion, advertisement, and influencing the mind. So in terms of taste, I like this.
I was actually quite surprised that for the potato chips, the preference for the house brand was overwhelming. People said they just tasted better. As for the other two snacks, there did not seem to be much of a taste difference between the branded and the house brand.
Which leaves me with one more category of products to test, household cleaners. About 76% of our survey respondents who buy house brands say they also go for household cleaners like dishwashing liquid. If I pick this house brand dishwashing soap over this branded one, I'll be saving almost 50 cents. Are house brand dishwashing soap as good as branded ones? I've roped in a lab for my next test. And my test subjects, these pans. 20 ml of curry sauce will be poured on two stainless steel pans. One will be washed with house brand dishwashing liquid, while the other with a branded one. I've rinsed each pot three times and now I shall be collecting the residual water into these clear bottles. With a bad dishwashing liquid, it's probably going to be grease and soap in the residual water. Left, right. I'm bringing these samples to Tan Tuan Piang, who has been testing wastewater for nearly 20 years.
What are the parameters by which the water is analysed?
Parameter testers are colour, turbidity, detergent and oil and grease. We really know colours. But turbidity, maybe some most people may not understand what turbidity. So I'll show you an example.
Okay.
So this is clear, okay. So they see something that is you can't see very clearly, it's called turbidity.
So let me just clarify that less turbidity is better than more turbidity.
Yes, correct.
The third parameter you mentioned was detergent. What do you mean by that?
Detergent is actually the soapy methods actually to remove the oil that is maybe contaminated the pans. After that, we need to able to rinse it off so it won't be any residue actually stay on the pans.
The last parameter was oil and grease. Explain that.
When we do cooking, the oil may stick on the pan. So we need to determine how effective the detergent to be able to wash away all the oil that stick on the pans. So for an effective dishwashing liquid, the rinse water should be as clear as possible and there shouldn't be any oil and grease and detergent residue.
Now let's have the results. How did the two dishwashing liquids compare?
Okay, sure. So Diana, look at this. This is the branded. Do
okay.
you see anything?
It looks crystal clear to me.
Yes, very good. So this is a house brand. Do you see any colour?
It also looks crystal clear to me. What does this mean?
So basically for the four pairings that tested, their results are quite comparable. It means that both dishwashing liquid are effective and they're able to remove what they're supposed to remove, the oil and grease, the dirt, whatever inside the pans.
Is one better than the other?
No. They are actually quite comparable.
Wow.
In effectiveness.
Wow.
Yes.
So whether it's the nutrition of household essentials, the taste of their snacks, or the cleaning prowess of household cleaners, house brands do hold up when it comes to quality.
At this point in my journey, I'm seriously looking at my grocery needs to see which products I can switch to house brands. But while they've addressed quality and price, the retailers still need to address the perceptions of house brands.
So this is really next level. Organic extra virgin coconut oil.
After several tests, I found that Singapore's house brand products do match their branded counterparts when it comes to quality. I want to know how retailers are able to match them in terms of quality while pricing them cheaper. So I'm meeting Marcus Wong from FairPrice. He has been managing FairPrice's house brand portfolio for the past 3 years.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Where do we start?
Shall we go here?
Yeah, yeah.
I saw your advertising tagline for your house brands, more quality for less. How do you do it?
It happens in two areas. Firstly, it's in terms of the product cost. We source globally from more than 55 countries and 450 suppliers, looking for the right supplier to give us the lowest cost possible. In some instances, there are middlemen in the whole process who acts as a bridge between the manufacturing facility and the retailers. We try to work directly with the manufacturing facility or the supplier, and we pass the cost savings from this to the consumers in terms of lower prices. Secondly, it's also about operating costs. While we do have people managing the house brands and we do some basic marketing and branding, we don't overinvest in it.
Okay, so this looks very well packaged to me. Where do you cut costs from here?
How we cut costs from here, first is that the packaging is actually a standard packaging from the supplier. Number two is initially when we launched the product, we did some communication to get the initial awareness up. But after that, consumers themselves share among their friends and family, and then that allows us to not have to continue to spend on marketing dollars to drive the sales and awareness.
Why would the manufacturers want to sell this product to you as a house brand?
There are different motivations for different manufacturers. Some of them, they have excess capacity. In order to optimize the capacity, they work with multiple brands to manufacture for them. If you think about it, a house brand is just like any other brand, and they are open to working with multiple brands in order to do that.
So what you're saying is that you go direct to the supplier, and you are actually getting more or less the same product.
Yep, there are manufacturers who manufacture for both branded products and house brands.
How do you decide what house brand products to develop?
Well, Diana, why don't I show you? Let's walk over to the oil section.
Okay, yeah. Oil.
Yes. So Diana, over the last few years, we have developed things like extra virgin olive oil and even newly introduced organic 100% cold-pressed coconut oil to meet those changing needs in the consumers.
Okay, so this is really next level. From oil as basic necessities and essentials, we've got organic extra virgin coconut oil.
Yes.
What is your motivation for developing such products?
Right. So house brands used to be meeting only the very basic essential needs, rice, oil, sugar, and so on. But as consumer taste changes, and as the different segments have different needs, we have to meet those needs in a better way. So we look at our data, and then we look at where we are underserving them, and where there's an opportunity for us to expand our range to meet those needs.
The effort seems to have paid off. FairPrice, Singapore's largest supermarket retailer, says sales of its house brand products have grown by 20% over the past 3 years. But even as sales increase, can retailers address the perception that house brand products have inferior quality?
In a bid to win over the skeptical minds of consumers, online retailer Redmart, which only started selling house brand products in 2015, has a new strategy, and it involves these. These fish balls come under Redmart's co-branded range. That means they carry both the Redmart name and their partner's name on the packaging. In this case, the tie-up is with Michelin award-winning chef Douglas Ng. I'm meeting the head of Redmart, Jolene Huang, to find out if such collaborations can improve the perception of house brands.
Diana, take a look at the fish balls that we just packed for our customers. These fish balls don't come cheap. They're about $6 for a pack of 15. I mean, for $6, I can buy many more fish balls at the market. Who would buy them?
So we started off Redmart House Brand with a series of like essential goods like what you see behind. And these essential goods slowly evolved into how we want to meet the sophisticated customer needs.
Why do you think it takes collaborating with an award-winning chef to improve the perception of house brands?
So the idea is not to improve the perception of house brand. The idea is to meet the customer needs in terms of providing the range that they want to have and also giving them an alternative on better tasting products that they are not able to find in the supermarket outside or even at online supermarkets.
House brand started out with a mission to provide quality products at affordable prices. Would you say that you have deviated from that mission?
I wouldn't say so. What we have done over the years is to grow the range to about 500 products. We still focus on quality, affordable prices that allows customers to bring back what they need at the most convenience using a Redmart delivery.
Moving forward, is this the direction that your house brand will take?
It will fall back to fundamentals at the end of the day. Quality, affordable range. And as we go into partnerships, we will at the same time strive for products that are what customers need. So it will still remain the same.
House brand started with the mission to offer affordable products at the same quality. But with new retailers vying in the same space, these staples are evolving. New product range, co-branding strategies, and better marketing ploys. While this means that they may no longer be the cheapest on the shelves all of the time, it's still a win for us because there is a wider range to choose from. So, grocery shopping has never been more fun.